Karna was the son of Lord Surya and Kunti Devi. He was born before the marriage of Kunti to King Pandu. So Karna was abandoned in the river Ganga. A charioteer of Duryodhana, Adiratha, and his wife Radha took care of him. He excelled in everything. Since he was brought up by a charioteer, he was considered to be of lower caste. Krishna knows about the secret of Karna's birth and wants to bring him to the Pandava army. He doesn't want him to die along with Duryodhana. One day, Krishna took Karna in his chariot, drove away out of the city and reached a lonely place. Both of them got down from the chariot.
Krishna, why have you brought me here?
Krishna smiles. Karna was not able to make out the secret behind the smile.
Karna, you are a good man. You know the most subtle shades of Dharma. Why are you with the sinful Duryodhana? Your knowledge of the Vedas is profound and deep. You understand the Shastras. You are an embodiment of Dharma. But still, you are with the unrighteous. Why is it so?
Karna smiles.
Krishna, you are right. A person who follows the Dharma should not side with the unrighteous. But the case of Duryodhana is different. He is my friend. Everyone in the world had doubts about my bravery. Everyone insulted me because I was a son of a charioteer. Duryodhana is the only one who came to my help then.
That's because he knows how to use you.
But Krishna, he could have taken me as a servant. He accepted me as a friend and equal. Many years ago, I came to Hastinapura in search of a job to earn a living. It coincided with a tournament which was being held there to celebrate the completion of the education of the Kuru princes at the ashram of their teacher Dronacharya.
Drona loves Arjuna.
Drona cannot accept anyone other than Arjuna. Earlier, Drona had refused to accept me as a pupil, as I was a Sutaputra. I had to go to Lord Parashuram to learn the art of warfare, but even he cursed me because I had lied to him about my birth.
Drona has his own ways.
They were displaying the skills learned from their guru. When I reached the venue of the tournament, I could not bear the pride shown by Arjuna about his skills in archery.
Of course, Karna. Arjuna is a great warrior.
Krishna, one should not be proud and arrogant. I could excel Arjuna. He could not outstrip me in a duel. I threw a challenge to him, but my courage in doing so was not appreciated. I was humiliated and insulted as I was not a Kshatriya. When I was insulted by the Pandavas, Duryodhana came to my rescue. He made me the king of Anga.
He knows that you are skilled.
Krishna, he could have appointed me as a commander for his army instead of making me a king.
But none of his men are as brave and mighty as you.
Krishna, I am not arrogant and proud. I know I am good, but there could be a superior person anywhere.
In his heart, Krishna admires the attitude.
Krishna, in front of the whole country, the princess and the guru humiliated me. But Duryodhana came to my rescue. Whether he gives the kingdom or not, the help he has done to me at the time of need is indeed matchless. I am ready to even give my life for him. Krishna, when I asked him what I could do in return, he took my hand and said, "I want only your friendship and nothing else."
Karna, here you are. You are a true warrior, a true Kshatriya, a man of great attitude.
Karna turns to Krishna.
I mean it, Karna. You are a true Kshatriya. Karna, the debt of gratitude is the most difficult to repay. But do you know about your birth? Do you know who your mother and father are?
I don't, Krishna. But sometimes I get a dream. It comes repeatedly. A royal princess abandons me as I was born before her marriage. My rearing takes place at the hands of Adhiratha and his wife, Radha. Adhiratha had found me floating in a basket on the waves of Mother Ganga. He gave me to his wife Radha. Since then, they have been my mother and father. They spared no efforts to bring me up. They lavished me with all the love and affection in the world. I too love them. I do not wish to know about the mother who gave me birth.
Krishna looks at Karna in a significant manner.
She might have forgotten me. She might have had more sons. Earlier I used to get the dream often, but subsequently it became less and less frequent. As she might have got some more sons, she might have forgotten me completely. Remembering me very rarely, I do not grieve. Radha is my mother and Adhiratha is my father.
Krishna's eyes were full of tears. He looked at Karna with infinite compassion.
Karna, you are right. Your mother's a princess. She had to abandon you for the reason you correctly guessed. She has many sons now, but she can never forget her first handsome son, who was born wearing divine Kavacha and Kundala. She could never fill the emptiness of her heart caused by you. Though she has other children, her heart is still empty.
Karna was surprised to hear all this.
That means I am not a Sutaputra. I am a Kshatriya. Is it true? You talk as if you know my mother. Who is she? Is she living? Can I see her? Oh, kindly tell me, Krishna.
The truth is, your mother has 5 sons who are the best warriors in the world.
Karna's breath was taken away by this revelation.
Is it Kunti Devi? Is she my mother and the Pandavas my brothers? Is it true, Krishna?
It is true, Karna. You are the eldest of the Pandavas and the first born to Kunti. You were born before the marriage of Kunti when she was young.
Krishna, you may know who my father is. Kindly tell me who he is.
Your favorite god, Surya, is your father.
Karna remained in a trance for some time. Then he opened his eyes.
Krishna, really, I am the most unfortunate among human beings. Lord Sun is my father. Kunti is my mother. The noblest Yudhishthira, the most powerful Bhima, the greatest archer Arjuna, the most handsome Nakula and the most learned Sahadeva are my younger brothers. And I am known as a Sutaputra in the world. Lord Parashurama must have known the secret through his inner vision. That is why he cursed me that I would forget all my skills at the moment I need them the most.
A stream of hot tears flowed from the eyes of Karna. After some time, he wiped his tears.
My Lord, you knew this secret all the time. Why didn't you tell me all this earlier? Why have you chosen to reveal this to me at this time? I was so eager to know about my mother and father all these years. Why are you telling all this only now?
Krishna was full of compassion for Karna.
I want to save you from death. I want you to live. Had I told this earlier, people would have tried to finish you off by foul means. According to Dharma, you are the eldest of the Pandavas. You are my cousin. You shall be announced king and all the Pandavas shall be there to serve you and obey your command. You are like Yudhishthira in righteousness. You are compassionate like Bhima. You are equal to Arjuna in archery and warfare. You are more handsome than Nakula and you are wise and learned like Sahadeva. You should enjoy the kingdom of the earth. Come, join me. I shall give you the kingdom of the world. You will also gain 5 brothers and your mother.
Karna laughed at when Krishna said this.
Why do you laugh, Karna?
My Lord, you have told me about my mother and brothers out of the infinite compassion you have for me. Undoubtedly, I am a Pandava by Dharma, but my mother Kunti Devi had forsaken me. She does not need me. I was brought up by Radha. I regard her as my mother and I am Radheya. Adhiratha is my father in the same way. They have given me the love and affection due to a son.
The entire world and the power of ruling it means nothing to me in the face of their love. The splendor of the entire world cannot lure me to abandon the path of the truth.
Karna, you still want to be with Duryodhana?
Krishna, Duryodhana is my friend and I am grateful and indebted to him. I have pledged my support for him in the war. I cannot go back on my promise. The kingdom of the entire world, good family, name, eternal fame, 5 godlike brothers and a mother like Kunti Devi. Her love and affection hold immense attraction and charm. But the truth is dearer to me. You want me to come under your shelter to save me from death. The Pandavas are under your protection. Thus, they are invincible. No one can defeat them.
Karna, you may lose your life if you are with Duryodhana.
Krishna, I have to be with Duryodhana. I am the only hope for him. I shall die with him in the battlefield and thus attain release from the bondage of life. I have always been chosen as a target by fate. I have been itching to fight with Arjuna in the war. By revealing that he is my younger brother, you have killed my enthusiasm. Now, I do not wish to fight him, though it has been a long cherished desire to meet him in a final duel. Since you have disclosed the secret of my birth at such a crucial juncture, I should be very angry with you. But it is not possible for anyone to be angry with you, Krishna. But I want to ask you something.
Hearing this, Krishna immediately agreed to grant Karna whatever he desired. Karna took Krishna's hand in his hands.
My Lord, you know the secret of my birth, but I request you not to disclose this to the Pandavas till I live. If the Pandavas come to know of my identity, they will not be able to fight me. Yudhishthira is the embodiment of Dharma. I wish he becomes the emperor. He is fully competent to become the greatest emperor in the world under your guidance. I know that the Pandavas will win and we will lose. Throughout my life, I endeavored to save my reputation. I never allowed anything to sully my fair renown. I am desirous of a short but glorious life. I should get fame in my defeat and even in my death.
Krishna smiled.
How come you are so sure of the victory of the Pandavas?
This war of Kurukshetra is a sacrifice. You are the presiding deity and Arjuna is the chief priest. All other Pandavas are acting only on your directions. The sons of Dhritarashtra, Bhishma, Drona, Kripa and all other soldiers, warriors and me are the offerings in this sacrifice. All will attain heaven by laying down their lives in this battlefield. I too hope to see you in heaven. I now beg you to leave.
Krishna embraced Karna as he took his hands into his own. His eyes were filled with tears. He looked at Karna with deep love and compassion. Both walked towards the chariot.
Karna, you are the greatest of the Pandavas. None can be as fair and noble as you. I would love to be your charioteer. The most handsome man, I feel proud to see you. You are a true Kshatriya. Remember, only great qualities make a true Kshatriya.
Krishna moved towards the chariot with a heavy heart. Karna followed him without uttering a word. Arjuna, the greatest warrior of the Pandavas, did not like Krishna's admiration for Karna. On the second day of the battle, in the great war of Kurukshetra, Arjuna felt proud that Krishna was his charioteer and his servant. He felt that as a master, he should get down from the chariot after Krishna and not before him.
Krishna, why are you not getting down before me? You are the charioteer and you should get down before me.
Arjuna, there is a reason behind what I do. So get down first and you will come to know the reason later.
What will happen if you get down first? Will someone kill me? I'm ready to face anybody.
Arjuna, you are responsible for your army. All your brothers depend on you. Keep that in mind and do as I say.
I am well versed in warfare and none dare face me. Even your favorite Karna is going to run away from this battlefield in a few more days.
Arjuna, what do you know about Karna?
Krishna, you told me that he has given his armor to Lord Indra and is the most generous of all warriors, is it not?
Arjuna, listen. He is a man of noble qualities. He has great qualities that others don't have.
Krishna, you are admiring Karna, knowing pretty well that he is not our ally.
I don't support him, but that does not mean that I should be blind to his virtues.
What indeed are the virtues of the great Karna?
One day, before taking his bath, he was applying oil to his head from a jeweled cup. Karna had taken the oil in his right hand and rubbed it well into his hair. I went there.
Welcome, Krishna. What a pleasant surprise. Please be seated. I will come back in a few minutes.
Karna, I have come to demand the cup from you.
I am surprised that you, the master of the universe, have a desire for this paltry thing, Krishna. But who am I to ask you questions? Here is the cup. I gift it to you, Krishna.
He placed it in the Lord's right hand with his left hand.
Karna, you are giving it with your left hand?
Pardon me, Krishna. My right hand is smeared with oil. I was afraid that if I take time to wash the hand before giving the cup to you, the wayward mind, which now has agreed to the gift, might discover some argument not to accede to your request.
Krishna was surprised by this answer.
This is the reason why I acted immediately and passed it on to you, regardless of the breach of a rule of etiquette. Please sympathize with me and pardon me, Krishna. I knew well that the human mind is unsteady.
Detachment and discipline can tame the human mind, Karna. You have both these qualities. I admire your compassion.
Krishna leaves with the cup.
Arjuna, do you understand now?
Forgive me, Krishna.
Now, please get down from the chariot.
Still, you want me to get down first from the chariot, Krishna?
But Krishna was adamant.
Arjuna, you must come down first.
After wasting a long time, pleading, protesting and praying, Arjuna got down, very unwillingly, swallowing his pride. As Krishna came down, immediately the chariot went up in flames. Arjuna was thrown a few yards away. Slowly he got up.
What's happening here? Why has the chariot gone up in flames?
The incendiary arrows and missile that had struck the chariot were powerless as long as I was on it. But when my presence was no longer there, they set the chariot on fire.
Oh no!
Arjuna bows down his head.
If I had gone down before you, imagine what would have happened to you.
I will shed my ego, my lord. I now understood the great qualities of Karna.
Arjuna, Karna is a man of great strength. He is a true Kshatriya and the height of magnanimity. No one can match him in his qualities or in might.
Krishna showed Arjuna that every act and word of the Lord had significance and a purpose which none can gauge. Egoism is a tough enemy, and it requires constant vigilance to conquer it.